रिकॉर्डिंग हो तो रहा है,
उस वक्त पता नहीं कैसे नहीं हुआ, फिर से कर लें उसको जो है।
एक बार चेक कर लेना, बीच में यहाँ पे आते हैं ना जैसे।
हाँ तो रहा है
बीच में चेक
ना, ना ठीक हो रहा है उस वक्त जो है, नहीं हो रहा होगा किसी कारण। टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल स्पीक ऑन द यूज ऑफ द इनको टर्म्स। What is the use of the Incoterms in the international business? The use of the Incoterm is in the syllabus of the global logistics and the warehousing management. Here is the case study of the use of the Incoterms. Hence, at first, the case study about the Japanese importers will be dealt, then the case study about the Russian importers in the use of the Incoterms that will be discussed today. The use of the Incoterms 2000 in the C4 trade with the Norway. The study of the 10 cases in Japan show that the most used term of the delivery in the C4 trade with the Norway was CIF. 7 companies of the 10 interviewed used the term, followed by FOV. 6 companies are using the Incoterms. The term CFR using 3 companies was rarely used. The term XW was rarely, very rarely used, named only by the one company. None of the company participating in the case study changed the practice of the use of the Incoterms 2000 recently. All of them used these terms of the delivery without changes for many years. A company might also use different terms of the delivery from the Incoterms 2000 in the different situations and with different suppliers. A summary of the Incoterms 2000 used by the Japanese importers participated in the study is presented in Figure 8. Figure 8, Incoterms 2000 used by the Japanese importers in the C4 trade with the Norway. X, EXW, CFR, FOV, CIF. CIF is used mostly by the 7 companies, FOV by the 6 companies, CFR by the 3 companies, where EXW by the 1 company only. Factors influencing the choice of the Incoterm 2000. Among the factors that influenced the choice of the Incoterms 2000, first of all, the Japanese respondent named the type of the fish. The collected information on this factor shows that the companies tend to use FOV for mackerel and capelin, when CFR and CIF for salmon and other fish. The respondent found it difficult to develop on why they use the term Incoterms 2000 for the named specific fish species. Another factor named by the Japanese respondent as important for the choice of the term of the delivery is the volume of the delivery. It is the logical to suppose that the bigger volumes increase the value of the delivery. The respondents underlined that FOV was used for the bigger volumes, greater values, and the CFR for the smaller volumes, lower value of the seafood. In these situations, the importers prefer to take more control over the delivery of the greater value, thus they take the responsibility of the transportation. In the cases when a smaller value of the seafood are to be delivered, the value of the consignment is lower and the Japanese importer have less control over the transportation, which is usually arranged by the supplier. The study of the Japanese cases show that the intention to have more control over the delivery makes the importers to use EXW when the responsibility and risk for the exporter are minimal, though rarely, and more of FOV in the seafood trade. The supplier condition plays an important role in the choice of the term of the delivery. The CIF is usually stipulated by the supplier. All the respondents said that the use of the Incoterms 2000 was a common practice in the company that has been formed based on the experience of the trade with the Norway. The Japanese importer mentioned that the relationship with the insurance agency played an important role. This means that if the Japanese importers have a good relationship with the insurance company, they may get better insurance condition than if the insurance would be fulfilled by the Norwegian exporter. In this case, the Japanese importers prefer to use the term CFR, FOV, or the EXW. To summarize the Japanese importer's name, the following factor influencing the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in the seafood trade with the Norway: type of the fish, volumes, control over delivery, common practice, supplier's condition, and relationship with the insurer. These are the factors influencing the choice of the Incoterms 2000. Relationship quality and its influence on the choice of the Incoterm 2000. All the statements regarding the Japanese importer trust were estimated to be higher than the middle level 3. Only one segment got a relatively low estimation in the comparison with the others. It is concerned with the support from the Norwegian supplier in difficult time. In general, the importer's trust was estimated as a very good. See figure 9. 9 of 10 respondents say that they trusted the Norwegian supplier. Figure 9, importers trust Japanese respondent. Importers trust. The Norwegian supplier is open and honest with us. 4-3. The Norwegian supplier is knowledgeable about his product. 4-7. In difficult times, the Norwegian supplier will support us. 3-3. The Norwegian supplier is trustworthy. 4-7. These are the... During the interviews, the Japanese respondents were also asked by why they trusted or distrusted their Norwegian supplier. Categorizing the answer, first of all, the respondent mentioned the quality of relationship between them and Norwegian partners. They trusted their Norwegian supplier because of a long relationship, good understanding between us, and because to their point of the view, the Norwegian were reliable and the kind partners, trustable in the general. We importers feel happy working with the Norwegian. The Japanese importers also mentioned the performance of the Norwegian suppliers. The Norwegian suppliers were trustable because they fulfilled obligations, knew the market situation in Japan and the Norway, and thus this made it easier to establish relation, keep promises, had a business style, and were quick to respond. Some statement concerned quality of the seafood. The Japanese respondents say that they trusted Norwegian partner because Norwegian handled fish like a baby and Japanese like this, and because of the improved quality of seafood the recent year. Only one respondent said that they will not trust all Norwegian partners because quality was not the same. Importer satisfaction was estimated as good in the Japanese cases. The importers participated in the study generally felt satisfied through. They thought their Norwegian supplier could improve a lot. This segment got a satisfactory evaluation. See figure 10. Figure 10, importer satisfaction, Japanese respondent. Importer satisfaction, we are fully satisfied with the Norwegian supplier. 3-5. The Norwegian supplier can improve a lot. 2-6. Generally, we feel satisfied. 3-9. 8 of 10 respondents answered that they felt satisfied with the Norwegian supplier. The Japanese respondents were also asked why they were satisfied or dissatisfied. Categorizing the received answers, the respondent named and quality of relationship. They felt satisfied with their Norwegian supplier because of the good relationship. The quality of the seafood products was also one of the important factors for the importer satisfaction. Most of the Japanese importers were satisfied with their Norwegian suppliers because of the good and stable quality of the Norwegian seafood products. Though at the same time, two Japanese respondents say that they were not satisfied with their Norwegian supplier because of the low quality of the seafood. Although group of the statement concerned the performance of the Norwegian supplier on the Japanese market. The Japanese importers say that we are satisfied with the Norwegian supplier because Norwegian understood Japanese market and because Norwegian supplier had good communication with the customer. Those customers who sought to be dissatisfied said that Norwegian company ignored Japanese market. Norwegian supplier had a big influence on the marketers but did not understand Japanese market. besides the Japanese importers, we are not satisfied that the price for the seafood were high, and with that fact that the Norwegian government was practicing fishermen too much. Importers' commitment, despite the importers' expectation that the quality of the products from the Norwegian supplier would grow in the coming year. Good relationship with the supplier and the intention to continue buying from the Norwegian supplier. The Japanese importers who participated in the study tend to looking for the other suppliers, see figure 11. In general, the importers' commitment was estimated as good. Figure 11, importers' commitment, Japanese respondent. Importers' commitment. We are constantly looking for another supplier, 20. We have a good relationship with the Norwegian supplier and want to keep buying from him, 35. We will continue buying from this Norwegian supplier, 35. The quality of the products from the Norwegian supplier will grow in the coming year, 44. Channel conflict. The study showed a low level of the channel conflict between the Japanese importers and the Norwegian exporters, see figure 12. The means on the figure are not reversed and are shown on the scale from 1, low level of the conflict, and to 5, high level of the conflict. The examination of the Japanese cases showed a low level of the conflict, a smooth negotiation without the misunderstanding, clear and open business relationship. Figure 12, channel conflict, Japanese respond. The relationship with the Norwegian supplier is full of the conflict, 1-3. Non-negotiation with the Norwegian supplier are always rough, 1-6. We are differ in the opinion with the Norwegian supplier, 1-7. We get frustrated with the way the Norwegian supplier works, 1-1. Perceived relationship quality. The averages of the four relationship quality constructs are presented in the figure 13. In general, the relationship quality perceived by the Japanese importer was estimated as good. All constructs were estimated by the respondent as good, and only trust was estimated as very good. Perceived relationship quality, Japanese respondent. Satisfaction, 3-3. Commitment, 3-4. Channel conflict, 3-6. Trust, 4-3. This is the perceived relationship quality, that is the high quality. None of the respondent related the choice of the term delivery with the perceived relationship quality with their Norwegian supplier. At the same time, 2 of the 10 respondent associated increase in the export by their company with the increased relationship quality and their Norwegian partners. Russian importers. Use of the Incoterm 2000 in the seafood trade with the Norway. The Russian imported participated in the study mostly used the term CIF, 4 companies of the 6. The term FOV was also used by the many companies, 3 companies of the 6. The term CFR and FCA were used by the 2 companies. The term DS, DDU and FCA was rarely used by the company participating in the study. The Russian companies in all the cases in the present study used the different terms of the delivery for Incoterms 2000, depending on the situation, and thus various factors are involved in the decision making about the terms of the delivery. All the respondents underlined that the practice of use of the named Incoterms 2000 had not been changed the previous year, and their use was a common practice. A summary of the Incoterms 2000 used by the Russian respondents in the present figure 14. Figure 14, Incoterms 2000 used by the Russian importers in the seafood trade with the Norway. EXW 1, DDU 1, DES 1, FCA 2, CFR 2, FOV 3, CIF 4. That the factors influencing the choice of the Incoterms 2000. Among the factors crucial for the choice of the Incoterms 2000, the Russian respondent named the location of the seafood, which also determines the means of the transport. The respondent explained that if the seafood was located in the north of the Norway, it was usually transported by the trailers, and the term DDU was used for these cases by the some importers. If the seafood was located in the south of the Norway, it was carried by the marine transport, and the term DS was used. The term CPT was often used by the respondent when the seafood was delivered directly from the fishing. Grounds. Another important factor named by the Russian importers was the speed of the delivery. They underlined that it was quicker to transport seafood by the trucks when transportation by the marine transport took more time. Accordingly, when the speed was important for the delivery of the terms, FCA or DDU was used. The agreement between the partners upon the cost and risk for the carriage determines who arranges the transport. The investigation of the Russian cases so that in the case of the importer arrange the transport and bear expenses for that, FOV was generally used. If the exporter bear the responsibility for the transportation of the good, the term DS or DDU were used. The respondent explained that the sometimes for the importing company, it was cheaper to receive the goods at the exporter's store and to conduct an agreement with the carrier on the term of the FOV. Carriers often give their better condition to their best clients, and thus some Russian importers get better prices of the transportation. Thus, the relationship with the carrier were named as another important factor. One Russian importer said that the company chose to use the term CIF and the Norwegian partner organized the transport because it was convenient with the big volumes were imported and because the Norwegian supplier had better agreement with the carrier. None of the Russian respondents said that the type of the seafood influenced the choice of the term of the delivery. The Russian company underlined the calculation of the custom clearance fees as one of the most important factor for the choice of the importers. That is why the term CIF is not popular with the Russian importers, because the Norwegian exporters don't make insurance over the consignment. They usually have a year insurance agreement. This means that in case if the term CIF is used, the Norwegian exporter has to make an extra insurance for the specific consignment. The Russian importer in its turn has to include price for the fees, price of the transportation and insurance in order to calculate the custom fee. This makes the custom fee bigger. Despite of this fact, four companies participated in the study still use the term CIF. Though not often, in order to reduce the custom clearance fee, the respondents preferred to use the term CFR, FOV, FCO or XW. The demand for insurance was named as another factor influencing the use of the Incoterms 2000. In the Russian cases, the term CFR was mostly used because this term stipulates no special demand for the insurance, and this helps to keep the tax clearance payments low. Four of six respondents replied that the use of the Incoterms 2000 was a common practice in the company. Legislation obstacles play a crucial role in the Russian market. Due to the custom rules, the term DDP cannot be used in the seafood trade because the Norwegian company cannot fulfill Russian custom duty. This is impossible due to the fact that the necessary document for that are provided by the Russian company. Besides, it is much cheaper to use a Russian carrier for many Russian importers. Good relationship with the carrier give the Russian importers the advantage of saving on transportation. It is often cheaper to receive goods at the exporter's cold store and transport them by the FOB. To conclude, the following factors were named in the Russian cases as main for the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in the seafood import from the Norway. Common practice, calculation of the customs clearance fees, demand for insurance, legislation obstacle, relationship with the carrier, desirable speed of the delivery, location of the seafood. Relationship quality and its influence on the choice of the Incoterms 2000. All statements reflecting the Russian importers' trust got high estimation. As in the case with the Japanese response, only one statement got a relatively low estimation in comparison with the others. This statement concerned and expectation that the Norwegian supplier would support the importer in the difficult times. But the estimation of this statement was the above and the middle level, which showed a good trust in the exporter. In general, the importer's trust was estimated by very good see figure 15. Importer's trust, Russian exporter. Importer's trust, the Norwegian supplier is open and honest business 4-3. The Norwegian supplier is knowledgeable about its product 4-2. It's difficult time, the Norwegian supplier will support us 3-5. The Norwegian supplier is trustworthy 4-2. Five of six respondents say that they trusted the Norwegian supplier. Categorizing the answer, the performance of the Norwegian supplier was named by the Russian respondent. The Russian importers trusted the Norwegian supplier because they always fulfilled obligation. had good reputation because the Norwegian supplier always fulfilled the delivery and quality terms. The Russian respondent, who also named the quality of the seafood as one of the factors influencing their trust. The Norwegian supplier were trustful from their point of view because they were had been no experience when it would be necessary to reject the goods. Only one Russian respondent said that he did not trust the Norwegian supplier based on their recent bad experience. The Russian importer satisfaction was evaluated as good. The respondent expressed strongly the satisfaction with the Norwegian supplier, see figure 16. But at the same time, the respondent insisted on the fact that the exporter could improve much. This statement got a very low estimation and considerably differs from the estimation made in the Japanese cases. See figure 10 to compare. Figure 16, importer satisfaction, Russian respondent. Importer satisfaction is there. We are fully satisfied with the Norwegian supplier, 4-2. The Norwegian supplier can improve a lot, 0-7. Generally, we feel satisfied, 4-5. Five of six respondents were satisfied with the Norwegian supplier. The answer received when the Russian respondent were asked to develop on the why they were satisfied or dissatisfied can be grouped in the following category. First of all, the quality of the seafood was named. The Russian importers were satisfied with their Norwegian partners because Norwegian supplier did not try to sell goods of bad quality or the goods they could not sell to anyone for a long time, and also because satisfactory price and quality. Another category of the answer concerned with the Norwegian supplier performance. The Russian importers felt satisfied because Norwegian partners fulfilled their obligations and deliver were fulfilled in due time. Only one Russian supplier was not satisfied with their Norwegian supplier because sometime Norwegian company were cheating and it was difficult to get help from the Norwegian police or the government. Another Russian importer said they were satisfied in general, but the large Norwegian exporters lacked consensus in agreeing upon the price, which was influencing negatively the business transaction with the Russian partners. Importers' commitment. The Russian exporters expected that the quality of the products from the Norwegian supplier would grow in the coming years. The Russian cases showed that the companies had good relationship with their supplier and that they had the intention to continue buying from the Norwegian supplier. But at the same time, the Russian importers participated in the study were looking for the other suppliers. In general, the importers' commitment was estimated as good. See figure 17. Figure 17, importers' commitment, Russian respondent. Importers' commitment. We are constantly looking for the another supplier, 2-3. We have a good relationship with the Norwegian supplier and want to keep buying from him, 4-2. We will continue buying from the Norwegian supplier, 4-3. The quality of the products from the Norwegian supplier will grow in the coming years, 3-2. Channel conflict. The study sought a low level of the channel conflict between the Russian importer and the Norwegian importer. See figure 18. The means in the figure are not rigid and are shown on the scale from 1, low level of the conflict, to 5, high level of the conflict. The examination of the Russian cases showed no frustration in the way the Norwegian supplier worked. The Russian respondents were rarely differed in opinion with their supplier. The negotiation with the Norwegian supplier are rough and the conflict situation were rare. Figure 18, conflict. Channel conflict, Russian respondent. The relationship with the Norwegian supplier is full of conflict, 1-5. Negotiation with the Norwegian supplier are always rough, 1-8. We often offer in opinion with the Norwegian supplier, 1-7. We get frustrated with the way the Norwegian supplier works, 1-5. Perceived relationship quality. The average of the four construct of the relationship quality are presented in figure 19. In general, the relationship quality perceived by the Russian importer was estimated as good. All constructs were estimated by the respondent as good. Figure 19, perceived relationship quality, Russian respondent. Perceived relationship quality, satisfaction, 3-1. Conflicts, 3-4. Commitment, 3-5. Trust, 4-0. None of the Russian respondents related the choice of the term delivery with the perceived relationship quality with their Norwegian supplier. At the same time, two of six respondents associated the increase in the export by their company with their better relationship quality between them and their Norwegian supplier. Discussion limitation and the implication. In this chapter, the aggregated Japanese and Russian cases are compared in discussion section. Here, the use of the Incoterms 2000 factors important for the choice and the perceived relationship quality are discussed. At the end of the chapter, managerial implication, limitation, and future research proposal are presented. Discussion, Incoterms 2000 have been used in international seafood trade for years. However, to date, their use and the factors influencing the choice have not been explored. The main factors identified in the present study are different for the both country under investigation due to different geographical position, legal circumstances within the country, and the company's internal demands and intention. With this in mind, it is important to note that the factors that determine the choice of the Incoterms 2000 are unique for each company. This study is many ways differs from other studies regarding import-export relation. First and foremost, this is the first attempt to identify the main factors affecting the decision-making with respect to the delivery terms of the seafood export from the Norway. Secondly, two models of the main factors unique for the Russia and Japan are constructed, and the factors for both the country are analyzed. Thirdly, they were made an attempt to associate the relationship quality and the choice of the Incoterms 2000. And lastly, the perceived relationship quality by the importers in the Japan and Russia are evaluated and compared. The aim of the present study is to find out the which Incoterms 2000 are used in the export of the Norwegian seafood to Japan and Russia and identify the main factors of the choice of the terms delivery. Assuming that the company involved in the case study are representative for the population in Japan and Russia, respectively, the following conclusion can be drawn. The most used terms of the delivery in both countries are CIF, FOV, and CFR. The delivery term XEXW is used rarely in the both countries. The terms DDU, DES, and FCR used by the Russian importers, but not by the Japanese. All the respondents participating in the study explained that their company have been using these terms of delivery without changes for the many years. Based on the results of the study, the following main factors of the use of the Incoterms 2000 are identified. Number one, type of fish. Number two, volume. Number three, control over delivery. Number four, common practice. Number five, supplier's condition. Number six, calculation of the custom clearance fee. Number seven, demand for insurance. Number eight, legislation obstacles. Number nine, relation with the carrier. Number 10, relation with the insurer. 11, desirable speed of the delivery. Number 12, location of the seafood. Due to different business practices, the representative from both countries show different dependence on these factors. Some factors such as type of fish and volume seem to be very important for the Japanese importers, though they were insignificant for the Russian importers. Control over delivery and the condition of the supplier are also important in the Japanese case, but not in the Russian case. At the same time, for the Russian importers, calculation of the custom clearance fees, legislation obstacle, relation with the carrier, and location of the seafood are crucial for the decision making in respect of the Incoterms 2000. At the same time, the Japanese importers don't consider these factors to be the important. Table 11 presents the summary of the factor essential for the Japanese and Russian importers with regard to the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in the seafood trade with the Norway. Table 11, main factors for the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in Japan and Russia. Type of the fish, volume, value, control over delivery, common practice, condition of the supplier, calculation of the custom of the clearance fee, demand for the insurance, legislation obstacles, relation with the carrier, relation with the insurer, desirable speed of delivery, location of the feed, and which the Japanese importers are using, which the Russian importers are using. Here is marked here. The study shows that the type of fish is important only by the Japanese importer. For example, mackerel or capelin is usually delivered to Japan by the vessel using the delivery of the FOV. Salmon and other fish products are delivered using the term CFR and the CIF. The Japanese correspondent did not argument why they use these specific terms of delivery for different types of the seafood. Another important factor for the use of the delivery terms of the Japanese importer is the volume or the volume of delivery. The Japanese importer prefer FOB as the term delivery for the bigger volume, greater volume value, and the CFR for the smaller value, lower value of the goods. This is stipulated by the fact that the importers prefer to take more control over the consignment of the higher value. When the transportation of the seafood of the lower value is organized by the supplier, and thus the importer has a less control over the delivery. The Japanese importer occasionally faced the fact that the condition for the use of the certain Incoterms 2000 comes from the supplier. In these cases, the Norwegian supplier usually insists on the CIF being used. Another factor essential for the Japanese importer is the control over delivery. This means by using the terms FOB and CR, the company's importers have a more control over the delivery because of the earlier transfer of the risk to the importer. These factors, type and volume value of the seafood, condition of the supplier, control over the delivery, were not named by the Russian importers as important during the interview. Thus, it is possible to assume that these factors are not essential for the Russian importer. The calculation of the customs clearance fee is one of the main factors for the choice of the Incoterms 2000 for the Russian importers. That is why the company preferred to avoid using the term CIS, because in this case, the custom fee will be increased. In order to keep the custom fee lower, the Russian importers use the delivery terms CFR, FOB, FCA, and XZW. The factor regarding the custom clearance fee is not important for the Japanese importer. Another factor important for the Russian importer is connected with the clearance fee, namely the demand for the insurance. In Russia, the term CFR is used more often because there is no demand for insurance. Though the insurance anyway exists between the Norwegian exporters, usually have a year insurance against agreement for all consignment. The usage of CFR is very beneficial for the Russian importers because, as described above, this does not increase the custom clearance payment. In Russian regulation can restrict or not permit some terms of the delivery from being used. Hence, legislation is also one of the factors influencing the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in seafood trade. Thus, the delivery term DDP cannot be used in the seafood delivery for Norway to Russia. Relationship with the carrier are another main factor for the Russian importers. Good relationship with the carrier flow allows the Russian importers to save transport cost. At the same time, for the Japanese importers, the relationship with the insurer are an important factor that may influence the use of the Incoterms 2000. Good relationship with the insurer allow the Japanese importer to save the insurance cost. Desirable speed of delivery is named only by the Russian importers, though it is logical to suppose that this is also an important factor for the Japanese importers. In situation when the delivery should be fulfilled in shorter time, the term FCA and DDU are used by the Russian importers. The location is one of the factors named by the Russian importers that determines the use of the transport means and thus determines the Incoterms 2000. The seafood from the north of the Norway is usually transported by the trailers DDU used, and from the south of the Norway, it is transported by the sea DSEU. The term CPT is often used when the seafood is delivered directly from the fishing grounds. There is only one similarity between the Japanese and the Russian cases regarding the factors influencing the use of the term of the delivery. All the respondents from both countries underlined that the use of the Incoterm 2000 is mainly used on the con practice in the company. Another aim of the study is to identify the relationship quality influences the choice of the delivery term. None of the respondents in Russia or Japan connect the choice of the Incoterms 2000 with the relationship quality that they have their Norwegian supplier. Thus, relationship quality cannot be included as one of the factors that are under investigation in the present study. At the same time, some Japanese and Russian respondents associated increasing import for the Norwegian supplier with better relationship quality. Based on the study results, it is possible to construct model of the main factors that influence the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in Japan and Russia. See figures 20 and 21. The main factors for the choice of the Incoterms 2000 in the delivery of the second seafood from Norway to Japan: type of the fish, volume of value, common practice, relations with the insurer, control over delivery, condition of the supplier. This is the choice of the terms of the delivery, Incoterm 2000. The main factors for the choice of the Incoterm 2000 in the delivery of the seafood from Norway to Russia: calculation of customs of the clearance fee, legislation obstacles, location of the seafood, common practice, demand for insurance, desirable speed of the delivery, relation with the carrier, choice of terms of delivery in Incoterms 2000. The perceived relationship quality by the Japanese and Russian importers were evaluated by analyzing its construct, trust, satisfaction, commitment, and conflict level. Despite of the fact that the sampling size is insufficient for making generalization, it is possible to assume that the respondents participating in the study are representative for the population. In this case, comparing the result received from the Russian and the Japanese respondent, some conclusion can be made. The importer trust is estimated as very good in both the country. The Japanese importers have a stronger belief that the Norwegian supplier is trustworthy and that the Norwegian supplier is knowledgeable about their product. The Russian importers are sure that in difficult times, the Norwegian supplier will support them. In both countries, the openness and the honesty of the Norwegian supplier are estimated equally, see figure 9 and 15. The importer satisfaction is estimated as good in both the country. Comparing the means representing opinions of the importers in the Japan and Russia, the Russian importer show more satisfaction with the Norwegian exporter. At the same time, there is a considerable difference in the meaning regarding expression that the Norwegian suppliers can improve much. In this case, the Russian importers are less satisfied with the Norwegian exporter than the Japanese, see figure 10 and 16. The imported commitment is estimated good in both the country. The Russian importers are more certain that they will continue buying from the Norwegian supplier. The Japanese importers are surer that the quality of the product from the Norwegian supplier will grow in the coming year. Despite the satisfaction with the importers, importers in the both the country are constantly looking for the another supplier, see figure 11 and 7. 17. Comparing the means of the representing the channel conflicts in the Japan and Russia, the Japanese importers show to have less conflict situation, disagreement, and frustration than the Russian importer. In both the country, the channel conflicts are at a low level, see figure 12 and 18. The relationship quality perceived by the Russian and Japanese importer is estimated as good in both the company. The average means of the trust, satisfaction, commitment, and the conflicts in Japan and Russia are all above the middle level 3 and can be evaluated as good. In general, the relationship quality perceived by Japanese importer is better, judging by the higher means for all the construct. One of the construct, namely trust, is estimated very good in Japan. All the construct spelling the perceived relationship quality by the Russian importers are within the range from 3 to 4. On 5-point scale, see figure 13 to 19. When the respondents from both countries were asked to elaborate on the trust and why they feel satisfied with the Norwegian supplier, they named performance of the Norwegian importers, fulfill obligations, no market situation, etc., quality of the relationship, long relationship, good understanding, etc., and quality of the seafood, handle fish like a baby, improved quality, etc., as among the factors that influenced only two respondents. Two Japanese and one Russian said that they did not trust and are not satisfied with the Norwegian supplier. Managerial application. Despite of the study limitation presented later in the chapter, the main factors outlined through this study was being essential for the use of the Incoterms 2000 in the Japan and Russia potential for the managerial application. Managerial implication. Firstly, the models of the main factor present practical information for the Norwegian exporters and carrier of the seafood to Japan and Russia. The study gives an example and summarizes the practice in use the term of the delivery and at the same time identifies the exact region for the choice of the specific Incoterms 2000 in the seafood trade. The analysis of these factors gives a better understanding of the channel relationship between the Russian and Japanese importers and Norwegian exporters. Secondly, the estimated perceived relationship quality preponderance data that can be used by the Norwegian exporter for developing their advantages within the market. Understanding the way the importers evaluate the relationship may help the Norwegian supplier to contribute to the development of their business relationship with their partners. Although the study showed no connection between the relationship quality and the choice of the importer 2000, the relationship quality is still an important element in the business relation with the decision-making process. The study is carried out within the project for the carrier, both for Fresh Transport AS, Tromso. The project concerns the investigation of the supply chain, which includes the customs procedure, food safety, contract legislation issue, transport insurance, obligation and responsibility of the partner, and terms of the delivery in the second supply from Norway. The present study will be used for further analysis of the risk factors for carriers regarding the logistic lines for the seafood export from Norway. Limitations and future research. Like all study, this study also has limitations. Firstly, the study was limited to the case study involving Japan and Russian importers. This gives only one perspective on the quality of the relationship on the factors influencing the choice of Incoterm 2000, namely from the point view of the importers. The perception of the Norwegian supplier to relationship quality can be different, and their association with the about relationship quality and its effect on the choice of the delivery terms may also differ. The relationship quality in importer-exporter diets can be examined better if the researcher is focused on the importer-exporter diet. Then both the exporters and importers are involved. Besides, the constructs can be extended to, this will give a better insight into the problem and will the relationship quality to be evaluated thoroughly. The limited number of cases study in both the country presents a limiting factor to generalization made in the study results. A greater amount of cases will produce more accurate data on the use of the Incoterms 2000 and the perceived relationship quality. Another limitation of the study is that it is impossible to make a serious statistical analysis of the data regarding the perceived relationship quality in the Japanese and the Russian cases because of the smaller number of the cases involved in the study. That is why this study is mostly based on the description and some elements of the statistical analysis. Besides, the amount of the cases in Japan and Russia is unequal. This is due to the fact that the interviews with the Russian company were carried out during the first 3 months of the 2000, the busiest period of the year, and potential respondent had little time to participate in the interview. The result of this study also suggests several directions for the future research. One possibility is to extend this analysis to include the Norwegian exporters. This study focused only on the importers in the Japan and Russia who presented their points of the view on the problem of using Incoterms 2000 and the possible influence on the relationship quality. However, the Norwegian exporters may give valuable information regarding this issue. Another suggestion for the future research is to extend the study and examine the whole supply chain to Russia and Japan separately in order to identify all the important factors in the seafood supply from Norway. The issue of using Incoterms 2000 depends only a part of the problem connected with the seafood delivery. Other issues concerns customs and legal requirement, contractual law, quality control, insurance, and responsibility between party. And then references is given in this chapter. These are the references given in the chapter. Internet references are also given in this chapter.